Okay, good morning all. So yesterday we have started looking at this how to solve different kind of limits and limits question. Okay, so I'll just quickly recap what we did yesterday. Very brief explanation or recap. First thing we saw that limit to exist. Squeeze theorem. So first thing we saw that the limit to exist, we have left hand limit is equals to right hand limit and should be equals to a limiting value L, suppose, hai na? This is called as limiting value. Second point which we saw was that if limit does not exist, if we say that limit does not exist, then we have three conditions in this, three different kind of cases in this. The first case was when either left hand limit or right hand limit or both, है ना? We have left hand limit, right hand limit or both does not exist. Okay. Second was that if left hand limit and right hand limit exist but are not equal, they exist but are not equal, right? So in this case, and third case was when we have limit fluctuating, when we have too much oscillation, too much fluctuating value near the lim near near a point A, suppose, right? So one of the student was asking that limit of this form, in I think in your some Cengage book or somewhere it was given that undefined or variable to the power variable, right? And when variable is negative less than zero, then this limit does not exist. Why is it happening? See, when you are taking a variable, if it is negative, suppose you have minus of mod x to the power minus of mod x, right? Now if x is changing values, if suppose x is changing value and x is around 0.5, if x is around 0.5, right? Now see, when x is around 0.5, that means x is 1 by root 2, right? So some part this root will make will be somewhat some of the form of minus of negative something, which is undefined in maths, which is right complex, right? So that is why for there will be too much fluctuation. For even number it will be positive, for odd number it will be under root of something, right? So like that, or for even number, for even integers, for even values it will be positive, for odd values it will be negative, and so on, right? So around a particular point when this is negative, you will have too much of fluctuation. So that is why for this case also it will be not defined, hai na? Then we have seen okay, to find limit we have different forms or different ways of finding limit. So to find any limit, the first way of solving was direct substitution, right? In this direct substitution, we saw that directly substituting the values, because there was no indeterminate form, so directly substituting the values were giving you the value of the limit. Now second we will see now. One more thing which we saw yesterday was indeterminate form, right? What does actually indeterminate form means? Suppose sometime the function at a particular value f of a might be undefined, okay? So or 0 by 0, simplest form, 0 by 0. From this all the other 7 forms were derived. So suppose if it is 0 by 0 form, hai na, or something by zero form, so what happens is, for indeterminate form, because the function value at a is undefined, we might think that in its neighborhood the function might have an existing limit, or might be limit does not exist, might be undefined. The neighborhood also is undefined, okay? Might be that around that neighborhood it is defined, or might be around that neighborhood it is not defined. So because of this uncertainty, we will call it as indeterminate form. and then on the basis of each question we will try separate question and we'll see whether the limit will exist or not. Okay, so now let's move further, and today we will start solving the limit question using rationalization and factorization. So yesterday also we have solved one or two questions. Okay, so I have given you this question, so I hope everybody must have tried this question and everybody was able to solve. For this question, everyone has tried this question. So yes, so in the denominator we have 1 plus n, 1 plus 2 square, 1 square plus 2 square till n square, right? So we know the sum of squares of first n natural number, the sum of squares of first n natural is simply n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 by 6, right? In numerator we have 1 into n plus 2 into n minus 1 plus 3 into n minus 2 till we have n into n minus 1, we can say n minus 1 minus n, sorry, n minus n minus 1, sorry, n minus n minus 1. Okay, so if I'll open the brackets, then for everyone this will get multiplied, 3 will get multiplied, and n will get multiplied, right? So this all we will get will be 1 into n plus 2 into n plus 3 into n till n into n. So this is simply n into sum of first n natural number. So 1 plus 2 plus 3 till n. So this is n into n plus 1 by 2, which is the sum of first n natural number. Okay, so this becomes, again, in numerator also we have the factor of n cube. We have the factor of n cube from this, right? In denominator also we will have a factor of n cube, because n into n, we will have n cube. In numerator also, just by looking at this, we are having a factor of n cube. So that means this n cube and n cube will get cancelled. Also, if you look at the second part, so this is minus of 2 into 1, then we have minus of 3 into 2, then you have minus of 2, 3, then you have 4 into 3, and so on. And the last one is n into n minus 1. It means minus I will take common. So this is the series, right? The previous number I can write as 1 into 0 plus 2 into 1 plus 3 into 2 and so on till n into n minus 1. Okay. In sequence and series, we have seen this, how we will solve this. In sequence and series, we have seen how we will solve this. First way of solving was VN method. If you do not remember the formula for VN method, one thing you can do, you can multiply and divide. So what we will do, we will take a next number. So suppose you have 3 into 2. You will take the next number. So I will write smaller number first. So 2 into 3. So next number will be 4. The previous number will be 1. I will take the difference of these two. So difference of these two is 3. So I will multiply this whole series with 3 and divide the whole series with 3. So I will multiply this with 3. So I will multiply this whole series with 3 and divide this whole series with 3. 3 will get multiplied with each and every term. 3 will get multiplied with each and every term. So this is 3 into 1 into 0 plus 3 into 2 into 1 plus 3 into 3 into 2 and so on. 3 into n minus 1. All these 3 I can change. In this case, next number. I will write smaller first and larger one second. So this is 3 into 0 into 1, 3 into 1 into 2, 3 into 2 into 3, and 3 into n minus 1 into n. Okay. So 3 I can write as next number minus the previous number. So this 3 I can write as 0 into 1 into next number will be 2 minus of minus 1. Okay. This thing I can write plus 3, plus 1 into 2 into 3 I can write as next number, which is 3 minus 0, 3 minus 0. Plus 2 into 3, 3 I can write as again 3 as 4 minus 1 and so on. So this one also I can write as n minus 1 into n. The next number will be n plus 1 and the previous number will be n minus 2. Sorry, the previous number will be n minus 2. So this will be in minus. So this will be minus. When I will multiply these values, what will I get? So see, I will solve it in the next page. So when I will open these brackets, so this is 0 into 1, 2 minus of minus 1 plus 1 into 2, 2 into 3, and the last one was n into n minus 1. And this was n plus 1 minus of n minus 2. This is 2, 3 minus 0. This is 4 minus 1 plus. Okay, so when I will multiply these one, so this will become 0 into 1 into 2 minus of minus 1 into 0 into 1 plus. This will become 1 into 2 into 3, 1 into 2 into 3 minus of 0 into 1 into 2. This will become, so I will write. This will become 1 into 2 into 3 minus of 0 into 1 into 2. Next one will become 2 into 3 into 4 minus of 1 into 2 into 3. Next one will become 3 into 4 into 5. Next one will become 3. So this is 1, 2 into 3 into 4 and so on till the last one. Okay. So now I will see these terms. So I'm writing it one below the other. So these term will get cancelled. So this is 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3 will get cancelled. 2, 3, 4. 2, 3 will get cancelled. So these terms will get cancelled. That is why this is 0, 1, 2. 0, 1, 2 will get cancelled. This is 0. So only the second last term will remain. Okay. So all these terms will get cancelled. Only the second last term will remain. And then that we can write in terms of n. And then we can solve. Understood? That is why I'm multiplying this with 3 and dividing this with 3. This we have seen in sequence and series. This we have seen in sequence and series, how we can solve AGP, where how we can solve these kind of series where each term is a AGP. That means each term is getting multiplied, or next term is multiplied with each one and with an AP. Okay, so just copy this one. If you do not know this method, you can copy this method. This we have done in sequence and series. Yeah, if limit approach is infinity, then take out n common. How many factors you have n common, right? So suppose in numerator also you have n factor common. In the denominator also you have n factor common. N factor will get, okay, fine. I will solve. So see, so if we look at the last term, so last term was this, this will become, let's see what this will be. So this is n minus 1 into n plus 1 minus of, this will be n into n minus 1 into n minus 2, right? So last term will be n into n plus 1 into n minus 1, n plus 1 into n minus 1 minus of n into n minus 1 into n minus 2, right? This one will get cancelled with the previous one. This was 0. So the only term which we left out will be this. So this is n into n plus 1 into n minus 1. Okay. One other term was this one. This term. So n into n plus 1 by 2. This whole thing was divided by 3. So the previous, this was whole thing was multiplied with minus 1 also, because we took minus 1 common. The previous term was n into n plus 1 into n by 2, sum of natural numbers divided by whole thing divided by n into n plus 1 into n 2n plus 1 by 6. Okay, so here what I can take factor of n cube common. So when I will divide n cube common, I can divide this also with n cube. So see, this when I will divide with n cube whole thing, so this first part, this part will become n into n plus 1 into n divided by 2 into n cube minus n into n plus 1 into n minus 1 by 3 n cube whole thing divided by n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 divided by 6 into n cube, right? So this n cube I can separate. One n can be divided with this, one n can be divided with this, one n can be divided with this. Similarly for this one, n can be divided with this, n can be divided with this, n can be divided with this. So I'll show you what will happen now. Okay, so see, first n I will take here. So this n by n into n by n plus 1 by n, and this will become n by n, okay, divided by 2 minus n by n, this will be n by n plus 1 by n, this is n by n minus 1 by n, okay, this is divided by 3, and the denominator we have n by n into n by n plus 1 by n, 2 n by n plus 1 by n divided by 6. Now see, each n, this will become 1, 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 this will become 1. These all values will become 1. As n tends to infinity, this part will become 0. This part will tend to 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 0. So in the numerator, we will only have 1 plus 1. So this is 1 by 2 minus. This here will become 1 by 3. Whole thing divided by. This part will become 1. This is 2. 2 by 6. Okay. So whatever answer you will get from here. Understood? Fine. Okay. Understood, everyone? Okay, very good. Just copy this. This thing, multiplying with 3 and dividing with 3. I will give you one more example for this one. I will show you one more example for this one. How can you solve AGP these questions? Just copy this part. This is important. This part. This is multiplying with 3 and dividing with 3. Three by three, I will explain once again. This part I will explain once again. For AGP, this is a special way in which we will solve. Just copy this one also. Okay. I hope this one is okay for everyone. Fine. See. Suppose if you have a series like this, you have 1 into 2 into 3 plus 2 into 3 into 4 plus 3 into 4 into 5 plus 5 into 6 into 7 and so on. You can cancel out n plus 1. You can cancel out n into n plus 1. It won't make any difference. Like that also you can cancel out. It is same thing. You will get n into n plus 1 will get canceled out. The factor will be 1. Same thing, JB. Okay. If you have something like this, if you have something, some series like this, then remember how to solve it. Take the next term and the previous term. So next term will be 4. The previous term will be, the next term is 4. The previous will be 0. 4 minus 0, 4. Next term will be 5. The previous term will be 1. So 5 minus 1, 4. Next term will be 6. The previous term will be 6, 2. 6 minus 2, again 4. So you are having 4 as a, so next term and previous term, if you take the difference, you will get 4, right? Always next term and the previous term. Next term and the previous term, always 4. So what I can do, I can multiply this with 4 and divide this with 4. If I'm multiplying, I have to divide with, this is 4 also. So see, this 4 will get multiplied with each term. This 4 will get multiplied with each term separately, right? So 4 I can write for each term, 4 I can write separately. 4 I can break into two parts separately. For this one, I will write 4 as 4 minus 0. For this one, I will write 4 as 5 minus 1. For this one, I will write 4 as 6 minus 2. For next one, I will write 4 as 8 minus 4. Right? So this was multiplied with 1 into 2 into 3. This was multiplied with 2 into 3 into 4. This was multiplied with 3 into 4 into 5. 5 into 6 into 7 and so on. Right? Now, when I will multiply them separately, so this will become 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 minus 0 into 1 into 2 into 3. This will get multiplied. This will become 2 into 3 into 4 into 5 minus 1 into 2 into 3 into 4. The next term will get multiplied. So this will become 3 into 4 into 5 into 6 minus 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. So what is happening? These terms are getting cancelled because we have introduced a minus in the series. So these terms will get cancelled and you will get the second last term means some term will get left out in the end, and this is the thing which is getting left out. So that, so this is minus. So I think the second last term will get will remain, right? This second last term minus of this is zero, right? So this will be the sum of this whole series. Understood? So Viksha, did you understood the method now? Whenever you have series like this, when these terms are in AP, remember next term and the previous term. Next term, suppose the series was 2, 4, 6 plus 4, 6, 8 plus you had 6, 8, 10. So now the next term will be 8 and the previous term will be 0. So 8 minus 0, next term will be 10, previous term will be 2. 10 minus 2, 10, 12 and 2. Like this. Understood? Hena? Okay, very good. Okay, by 11th portion, that is why it is very important to for you to revise, to do whatever is being given at that time, to do it religiously, like to actually revise so that you do not have to worry about. Now, this part was done in 11th. I remember because I did it myself. And I did it in KNMS. I revised this part because AGP is a very important series in your sequence series. So you can do one thing. You can just revise AGP. AGP series or VN method. VN method. This is a part of VN method. There is one more. Yeah. There is one more form. 1 by 1 into 2 into 3 plus 1 by 2 into 3 into 4 plus 1 by 4 into 5 into 6 and so on. Right? This was also one of the method, right? You can also check for this one also. In this also, we will multiply and divide with the difference, but here we will take the difference of first and the last sum. 3 minus 1, 2. 4 minus 2, 2. 6 minus 4, 2. And then we will break 2 as 3 minus 1. So 1 into 2 into 3. So again, terms will get cancelled and you will have. So this is another method, hai na, where terms will be divided. Okay? So I hope this part is okay. Okay? Fine. Now this question, okay. I hope you have tried this one. When limit of x tending to 0, e to the power 1 by x minus 1 and e to the power 1 by x plus 1 does not exist. You have to show that it does not exist. Yes. Okay. So I'll solve it very quickly. So because they are saying it does not exist, that means it has to do something with left hand limit and right hand limit. Right? It has to do something with left hand limit and right hand limit. So what I will do in these cases, what I generally do is I take left hand limit as limit of h tending to 0 plus, I take left hand limit as h tending to 0 plus, that means a positive, very small positive quantity, e to the power minus 1 by h minus 1 upon e to the power 1 by h plus 1. E to the power 1 by minus 1 by h plus 1. This becomes a left hand limit. Understood? How does this become the left hand limit? I have taken separately this negative sign. I have taken this negative sign for the left hand side, and the magnitude is all defined by h. Magnitude is defined by h, and the sign is defined. I have taken sign as simply minus h. Understood? This will become my left hand limit. Right? Yeah. And the right hand limit will become limit of h tending to 0 plus, again a positive, very small positive quantity, e to the power 1 by h minus 1 on e to the power 1 by h plus 1. Okay, yes. So from here, yeah, h tending to 0 plus, this means minus 1 by h, this ultimately means 0 minus. This minus h combined with 1 by h combined with 0, this means 1 by 0 minus. You know, this minus 1 by h combined with minus, because h is tending to 0 plus, this combined will make minus 0 minus. But because we have to take care of the sign, that is why I'm writing it like this. You know? Okay, this, everybody understood? By this part, everybody understood? See, so that I can take this minus, so that I can work with this minus. Why have I written 0 plus? So that I can work with this minus. Now, when I will use this minus, so this will become 1 upon e to the power 1 by h minus 1, 1 upon e to the power 1 by h minus 1. So this, plus 1. So this will become 1 minus 1, e to the power 1 by h upon 1 plus e to the power 1 by h. Okay, right? Understood? Now, what I can do? I can divide both. You do not have to even write this part. Okay, so now as limit of h tending to 0 plus, as h tends to very small value, this becomes e to the power almost infinity. This almost becomes 1 by e to the power infinity minus 1 upon 1 by e to the power infinity plus 1. This is almost 0. This is almost 0. So this is minus 1 upon 1. This becomes minus 1. So left hand limit is equals to minus 1. Understood? And right hand limit. When I will take right hand limit. Understood? Yes. X was tending to 1. We could have done this again. We could have changed. We will see those questions in the next part. Understood? Right? Now in this case also, what we will do? By this part, everybody understood, or should I explain this part once again, or everybody understood? Is there any doubt? You can ask. Okay. On the right hand side, what we can do? Again, we can divide with e to the power 1 by h. So this will become 1 minus 1 by e to the power 1 by h. 1 plus 1 by e to the power minus 1 by h. Right. So now I have divided both sides with 1 by h. As a limit h tending to 0 plus, this will become 1 minus 1 by e to the power infinity upon 1 plus 1 by e to the power infinity. This is almost equal to 0. This is almost equal to 0. So this will be 1 by 1. This is 1. So right hand limit becomes. How you remove minus sign in power of e? Oh my God. Okay. X to the power minus 1 can also be written by 1 by x. So by taking 1 by e to the power, I have changed. Minus means 1 by something. Understood? Sir, I cannot understand why. Okay, see. Again, I'm explaining this part. See. Again, I'm explaining. Listen, please. Listen very carefully. Limit of x tending to 0 can be of two form. Can take two different ways. First is x tending to 0 minus, and this will be x tending to 0 plus. Fine. Let's check what is the approximate value. Let's check what are the approximate values. So this will be 0.00000001. Fine. This will be something like this. And this will be minus of 0.00000001. Right. Now in both cases, we can see that this is a very small value with a minus sign. And this is just a very small value. So what I will do, I will take this as, I can write this as minus of h tending to 0 plus. And this I can take h tending to 0 plus. Instead of x, I will simply substitute 0 plus and my left hand limit, I can write minus of h 0 plus. Now this till here, Jaya, did you understood what I am writing till here? Till here, if there was confusion, now is it clear why I am writing minus of h? As h tending to 0 plus, here simply h tending to 0 plus, very good. Now I will simply write left hand limit. So left hand limit will be limit of h tending to 0 plus. This will be, instead of x, I will substitute as this. So e to the power minus 1 by h minus 1 upon e to the power minus 1 by h plus 1. This will simply become minus 1 by h. I can take 1. So this is 1 by e to the power 1 by h minus 1. 1 upon e to the power 1 by h plus 1. Right? This, as h tends to 0, this is a limit. As h tends to 0, this part becomes infinity. Denominator becomes infinity. So this part goes to 0. This part goes to 0. So this is minus 1. Hena? Yes. And this is, this will become simply e to the power limit. Limit h tending to 0 plus, and this part will become e to the power 1 by h minus 1 e to the power 1 by h plus 1. Now because this will tend to 0, right, so this whole thing I can divide. So this is limit of h tending to 0 plus. So this will be 1 minus 1 by e to the power 1 by h, because I will divide 1 plus 1 by e to the power 1 by h. This part will be almost 0. This part will be almost 0. So this will become 1. Huh. हाउ माइनस केम सर? अरे लेफ्ट हैंड लिमिट विल बी जीरो माइनस ना, सो जीरो माइनस मीन्स नेगेटिव अ वेरी स्मॉल नंबर, नेगेटिव अ वेरी स्मॉल नंबर. आई एम टेकिंग नेगेटिव ऑफ अ वेरी स्मॉल नंबर विच इज एच. एच इज पॉजिटिव, माइनस ऑफ अ वेरी स्मॉल नंबर. ओके, अंडरस्टूड? You can also write, yes, you can also write, somebody is saying you can also write 0 minus h and 0 plus h. That is also perfectly fine. This also, this form is also perfectly fine. 0 minus h and 0 plus h. Okay? This form is also equally correct. You can also write 0 minus h and 0 plus h. It is same thing. Okay? So, I hope everybody understood this question. Okay? Next. Very good. Okay. Next, this one. You must have, how many of you actually differentiated this question? How many of you actually differentiated this question and found the answer? Many of you, I think, Srivatsan? Me, yes, Srivatsan, did you differentiate? Okay. See, this question can be solved without differentiation also. This question can be solved without differentiation also. See, this whole thing I can write as limit of x tending to 1. Okay. Now see, here I have x cube minus 1. Here I have x cube minus 1. Okay. So x cube minus 1 will have a factor of x minus 1 into x square plus 1 plus x. By this will have a factor like this. Yes. This will have a factor like this. Huh. Without differentiation, it is much easier. Yes. Now this also has a factor. X minus 1 can also be written as under root of x minus 1 into under the root of x plus 1. But this also has a further factor. So this whole thing can be written as this. Now, x as x tending to 1, we do not have any problem with this. We do not have any problem with this. We just have a problem with this part. This part is the one which is creating problem. Okay. That means in the numerator, and why have I changed this into root of x minus 1? Because in the numerator also, you will get some root of x minus 1 or something. Okay. So let's check. Let's check this one. So what we can do is, first, let's look at the numerator. So this is x to the power 1 by 3. This is minus 3. This minus 3 has been given for a particular reason. This minus 3 has been given for a particular reason, that this minus 3 can be divided into minus 1 plus root x minus 1 plus root of x into root x minus 1. Okay. This minus 3 I have divided into three parts. This minus 3 I have divided into three parts. This and this. Yes. Very good. Yes, Sundaram. Yes, very good. So this x to the power 1 by 3, x to the power 1 by 3 minus 1. This can be written as, but this is x to the power 1 by 3 minus 1. In denominator also, we have x minus 1, right? In denominator also, we have x minus 1. So what I will do, I will divide this whole thing with, so this part, when I'm breaking into x minus 1, so this whole thing was divided with x minus 1, x minus 1 and x minus 1, right? And this part I'm keeping separate. So 1 by x square plus 1 plus x. Okay, this part I'm keeping separate. So let's check what are these three values get converted into this part. So what I will do, x to the power 1 by 3 minus 1. This is x 1 by 3 whole cube minus 1. So this can be written as x to the power 1 by 3 minus 1. This thing can be written as x 1 by 3 minus 1 into x to the power 2 by 3 plus 1 plus x to the power 1 by 3, right? Now this factor and this factor gets cancelled. So this part will only become equals to 1 by x to the power 2 by 3 plus 1 plus x to the power 1 by 3. Let's check the second one. Let's check this part. So this is root of x minus 1 upon x minus 1. So this is root of x minus 1. This is root of x minus 1 into root of x plus 1. This and this gets cancelled. So this is 1 by root of x plus 1. This is the second part. Let's see the third part. This is third part. So this is x into x root. So this can be written as root of x to the power cube. But this can be written as root of x to the power cube minus 1. So this and denominator is x minus 1. This can be written as a cube minus b cube. A cube minus b cube is root x minus 1. A minus b into root x a square plus 1 plus root x into 1 divided by this is root x minus 1 into root x plus 1. Again, this and this gets cancelled. So this is x to the power x plus 1 plus root x divided by root x plus 1. First step, this part. Aray bachche, this is a cube minus 1. X we can write as x to the power 1 by 3. X we can write as x to the power 1 by 3 whole cube. So this is a cube minus 1. A cube minus b cube. A cube minus b cube is what? A minus b into a square plus b square plus ab. Right? So a square plus b square. This is 1 square plus ab. Right? So we can write this value as 1 by 3. We can write this as 1 by 2. We can write this as, this is 3 by 2. 3 by 2. As limit, limit of x tending to 1. Limit of x tending to 1. Limit of x tending to 1. So this becomes 1 by 3, 1 by 2, 3 by 2. This is again 3. Okay. Fine. So we can simply substitute the values and you will get the answer. Okay. I hope everybody understood. Is there anybody who did not understood? I hope everybody understood this part. So just copy this one. Just copy this one. This minus one separating was important. You know, without differentiation. If you'll differentiate also, then in the denominator, you have to differentiate 3 times. In the denominator, you have to differentiate 3 times for you to get the answer. So differentiation is much, much difficult or much time consuming than this one. Okay, I hope everybody understood. Yes. Okay, first time in itself will come. That is very good. Good, excellent. But remember, please do not use L'Hopital's rule. If you will use L'Hopital's rules now, I can guarantee you, you will not be able to understand limits and you will not be able to do any question if a question comes from limit in JEE Advanced. Remember this thing. In the exam, you will say, "Arey, sir was warning us." They will never give you a question in which, but a final answer you can find na. Ab everything I should not tell na. Final answer you can find by yourself. Okay. So I hope these two questions are okay. These two questions are okay. You can just nothing. There is nothing differentiation. Some idiot was saying that I have differentiated and I got the answer. So that is why I'm saying. Okay. Fine. Okay, so this question, is there any doubt in this question? Should I solve this one also? Anybody has solved this one? Okay, so let's see. So this is limit of x tending to 1. So this is x to the power 10 minus x cube. This is minus x to the power 7 plus 1. Yeah, this is very simple. X minus 1 whole square. So what I can do, I can factorize this. I can take x cube 7. So this is x to the power cube, x to the power 7 minus 1, right? X to the power 7 minus 1. From here, I will take minus 1 and this will be x to the power 7 minus 1 divided by x minus 1 whole square. So this is limit. Okay. This is a limit x tending to 1. So this will become x cube minus 1 and this is x to the power 7 minus 1 divided by x minus 1 whole square. X cube minus 1. This part I can write as x minus 1 into x plus 1 plus x square. And this part is x minus 1. So 1x minus 1 will get cancelled with this. Into x to the power 7 minus 1 I can write as x minus 1 into x to the power 6, x to the power 4, sorry, x to the power 6, x to the power 5 plus x to the power 4, x to the power 3, x to the power 2, x to the power 1 plus x to the power 0. And this whole thing divided by x minus 1. This x minus 1 gets cancelled with this. So this becomes directly, we can see this will become 3. This will become 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 into 3, 7, 21. So answer will be 21. Okay, fine. So this will get factorized into this form. This will get factorized into this form. You can solve. Okay, just copy this. I hope you guys know that this can get factorized into this part. Right? Fine. Yes. So let's write it. So that is why x minus 1 whole square. See, in limit question, remember if there is a zero in the denominator. If there is a zero in the denominator. So if you'll check f of 0 is 0 by 0. That means, okay, so Fine. So that means if you are having, if you are having any value, if you are having this thing, zero by zero form, if you are having zero by zero form, then what you can do is, that means some form of zero and zero will be cancelled. Some number which is approximating equal to zero will be getting cancelled in the numerator and denominator. Okay, one some zero converting to zero, some converting from numerator and denominator will be converting to zero, and which you can cancel out, right? So here also this is was converting to zero, this was converting to zero, also this was converting to zero, and this was converting to zero. So all those zeros which were making problem, those will be cancelled out, and remaining will be this. Okay, I have this one is okay, fine. Next, this one. So as x tending to infinity, again this is infinity minus infinity. If this is infinity minus infinity form, now we do not know whether this will be around. This will tend to a number, means this will have a limiting value, will have a limiting value or not. So what we can do? This is under root. In the numerator, you have under root divided by whole thing divided by 1. So I will rationalize this. So if I'll rationalize this, this will x square plus x plus 1 minus root of x square plus 1 into. So this will become root of x square plus x plus 1 plus root of x square plus 1 divided by root of x square plus x plus 1 plus root of x square plus 1. Okay. So now what I can do, I can now, this will get squared, right? So when this will get squared, yeah, so this will, when I will take this square minus this square, so this is x square plus x plus 1 minus x square minus 1, this and this gets cancelled, this and this gets cancelled, you will have x divided by, this is under the root of x square plus x plus 1 plus under the root of x square plus 1. Now from here we have x, from here I will take x common, and from here I will take x common. So if I'll take x common from, sorry, from here I will take x square common. From here also, I will take x square common. So I will take x square common from both of them. So one x factor will come out here. So this is 1 plus 1 by x plus 1 by x square. And second, this will become again 1 plus 1 by x. And here also x. 1 by x square. Right? This x and x will get cancelled. So you will simply have 1 upon under the root of 1 plus 1 by x plus 1 by x square plus 1 plus 1 by x square. Right? This will tend to 0, this will tend to 0, and this will tend to 0. So this will be 1 by 1 plus 1, 2. So answer will be 1 by 2. Okay, let's copy this one out. Okay, just copy this one also. Okay, fine. Okay, next, this one. This is a very simple. Again, if I substitute x is equals to a, so this will become a 0 by 0 form, I guess. This will become 0 by 0 form. So what we can do, we can simply rationalize this. So when I will rationalize this, that means I will rationalize both in numerator as well as denominator. So I will multiply root of 5x plus 4a plus root of x plus 8a in numerator as well as denominator. So root of 5x plus 4a plus root of x plus 8a in numerator denominator into, for rationalize this one also, root of x plus 3a minus root of 3, sorry, plus root of 3x, root of 3x plus a, and this one also root of x plus 3a plus, sorry, this is plus, root of 3x plus a, right? When this will get multiplied with this and this will get multiplied with this, you will get rationalized. So this will become 5x plus 4a 5x plus 4a minus x minus 8a, and this will become x plus 3a minus 3x minus a into this and this, right? Okay. So this x, sorry. This will become 4x minus 4a, and this will becomes minus 2x plus a. This will get cancelled out. This is 4. If I'll take minus 4 here, so this will come minus x plus a. If I'll take 2 common, so this is minus x plus a. This gets cancelled out. So you'll have minus 4 by 2. And you have this form, this factor, root of x plus 3a plus root of 3x plus a divided by 2a. Yes. Now this is root of x plus 3a plus root of 3x plus a. Right? Simply substitute x is equals to a, you will get the answer. Fine? Okay. This one is very clear. So this will get cancelled with minus 2. Minus 2, if you substitute x is equals to a, so this will become under the root of a will get cancelled out. So this will become 2 plus again 2, and this will be 2 plus 2. So 2, so minus 2. So you will get limit as minus 2. Okay. Let's check this one also out. Fine. This one was very simple. Next. Next, this part is very important. See, in your books and all, now the next method of solving will be by using standard expansion of some standard function. Okay. The thing is that how we were able to get these, how we were able to get these functions, है ना? So we can do this question, we can do this part in with two different methods. One is that I will explain you. One thing is that I can explain how you are getting these expansion. And the other thing is you can just mug up, because you do not need the explanation. You can just mug up and you can remember these expansion, and then I will tell you the trick to remember these expansion, and from there you can use. So anyway, if you want me to explain, I can explain. If you want to just remember them, you can just remember them. Anything you want. Because explanation is also not in your syllabus, but it's your wish. You can remember? Okay, fine. So I will tell you explanation. Okay, see, I will give you a very brief explanation, है ना? Very brief. If you're not able to understand also, it's no problem. If you're able to understand, that is good. Fine. So in maths, any function can be converted, any function can be represented, any function can be represented as a polynomial function. So suppose I am writing any trigonometric function or any exponential function or any logarithmic function, right? They can be expressed as a polynomial function. Polynomial function with infinite power. That means can be represented as a polynomial function of this form: a naught plus a1x plus a2x square plus a3x cube plus a4x4 and so on, right? Yes, it is a form of Taylor series. But what is actually Taylor series? That I'm gonna explain, है ना? So this all also remember, this Taylor series is only talked around a point. This Taylor series or this expansion is only talked around a particular point. A particular point. What do we mean by this? That any function can be expressed as a polynomial function of this form around a particular form. See, everybody knows what differentiation do to the to a function. Everybody knows what differentiation do to a function. Everyone. What do we actually get from differentiation? What do we actually get from differentiation? Does everybody knows what do we get from differentiation? Because this part will require a little bit of differentiation. Yes, slope of the graph. है ना? Yes, very good. Slope of the graph. And what does differentiation of a differentiation gives us? What does differentiation of the differentiation gives us? It tells us how the slope is changing. है ना? Double differentiation gives us change in slope. Yes. Triple differentiation means how the change in slope. So every time we are talking about the change of the previous next one, है ना? So dx d sorry d differentiation or f dash x tells us slope, है ना? F double dash x tells us slope of slope, स्लोप ऑफ अ स्लोप, एफ ट्रिपल डैश एक्स टेल्स अस स्लोप ऑफ एफ डबल डैश एक्स, है ना, एंड सो ऑन एंड सो ऑन. दिस विल कीप ऑन या कीप ऑन गोइंग, राइट. नाउ सी, So suppose if we are talking about sine x, है ना, and if I'm talking about sine x, this is sine x. Okay, now see, suppose if I'm talking about sine x, and if I will ask that around x is equals to pi by 2, I want to write this function sine of x as a polynomial function. Suppose if I want to write sine of x as a polynomial function, that is a naught x plus a naught x square and so on, right, and so on. Or suppose what I will do, first I will substitute the value of sine x as pi by 2. Suppose I will substitute the value of sine x as pi by 2. So when I substitute sine x as pi by 2, this will become equals to 1. This will become sine of x, sorry, this, or what I will do, I will shift my, or wait, we can say is, because here it will be a little bit confusing. So what I can say is that let's talk about sine x at around zero. Let's talk about around zero, because otherwise you will get a little bit confused, right? So sine x is this. So suppose I'm writing sine x as a naught plus a one x plus a two x square and so on till a plus a three x cube. Till a n, where n is tending to infinity, infinite series. This is an infinite polynomial function. Now see, if I will try to write this sine x as this. So what I will do? I will first substitute sine x as zero. I will substitute x as zero. So this will give me. These all part will become zero, and this will give me only a naught. So a naught I will get at zero. So that means sine x I can write as 0. I will substitute a naught as 0, a1x plus a2x square plus a3x cube and so on, right? Now, first thing I got is very rough. I got a very rough approximation that, okay, at this point here, the slope will be, so first thing I have to find it, the slope will be something like this. So what I will do, I will take a slope like this. Yes, right? So we know differentiation. So what I will do, I will differentiate sine x. Now, why am I differentiating sine x? See, when I will differentiate this one will get removed. This one will get removed. So sine differentiation, we will get cos of x is equals to, this part will get removed. We will have only a1 plus 2a2x plus 3a3x square plus 4a4x cube and so on, right? Now, again, what I will do, because I have to find around 0, so I will substitute x as 0. So cos of x as 0, this will become 1, is equals to a1. Remaining all the terms will become 0. So this will be 0 plus 0 plus 0 and so on. So this will become a1. Right, so I got the value of a2, I got the value of a1. Right, now how to get the value of a? Sorry, I got the value of a naught, I get the value of a1. How to get the value of a2? I will differentiate it once more. So I will get something like this. So when I will differentiate it once more, I will get minus of sine x is equals to a1 will be removed. This will become 2 into 1 into a2 plus, this will become 3 into 2 into a3 into x plus, this will become 4 into 3 into 2 into x square and so on, right? So now see, what is this? This is 2 factorial. What is this? This is 3 factorial. What is this? This is 4 factorial and so on. So every time the next power will get is getting coming in front of it. So again, I will substitute x is equals to 0. When I will substitute x is equals to 0, this is equals to 0, and a2 is equals to 0 by 2 factorial, right? A2 is equals to 0 by 2 factorial. So what we get value of a2? We got a2 as 0. Okay, now what I will do to get the value of a3, again I will differentiate. So when I will differentiate it once, so next step, what I will get? Minus of cos of x, this will become 0. This is 3 into 2 into 1, a3 plus, this is 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, x is x, and so on, right? Again, I will substitute x is equal to 0. This will become minus 1. And this is a3 is 3 factorial. So this a3 will become minus 1 upon 3 factorial, and so on. So likewise, by differentiating continuously again and again and again, I can find these values of a1, a0, a1, a2, a3, a4, a5, a6, and so on. Around x is equals to zero. Now see, what this actually is doing in terms of slope. So suppose I have a very magnified version of sine x. So suppose sine x was something like this. Sine x, I will make a very big curve. So this is, suppose this was sine x, right? So the first differentiation was giving me an approximate value of this. That is a line which is tan x, tan, which slope is 1, right? What does next differentiation gives us? Next differentiation gives us a little more curve. So the function will become, this polynomial function is now this. After second differentiation, the polynomial function becomes something like this. That means a little more approximation. Next differentiation, the function becomes something like this. That means little more approximate. Now little more approximate. Next differentiation, the function will become something like this. Okay? Something like this. I'm trying to be very close, right? So every differentiation makes the polynomial function closer and closer and closer and closer to the original function around that point. Understood? So I hope this part everybody understood. This was the original function, which was sine x. And with every differentiation, we are making a polynomial which is very closer and closer and closer representation of this curve around this point. Fine. I hope this part is okay for everyone. Are you able to understand why we are doing differentiation again and again and again? How Fourier series is coming? Double differentiation, how the graph looks, then at infinity differentiation, that will be equal to the function. Okay. It around that point. So suppose if I'm talking about the sine function at pi by 2. So first differentiation will give me what? First differentiation give me this slope. Second differentiation will give me something like this. It will give me a polynomial function, something like this. Third differentiation, it give me a polynomial function, something like this. Fourth will give me a polynomial function, something like this. Right? So that means on adding, I will get infinite differentiation, what I will get? I will get a polynomial function around this, something like this. Very close enough to the sine function. So this is what it mean by Taylor series, that around a particular point, we can represent a function using infinite differentiation into a polynomial function. And if you will check, these all functions are after differentiating and finding those almost coincide, but around this point only. Remember, around this point only. Afterward, it will be something else. Afterward, the function will be complete different functions. But just around this point, the function will be almost same. Because we are differentiating in infinite times and we are finding closer and closer and closer representation of a function in terms of a polynomial function. Okay. I hope you understood this part. Fine. I will share this slide with you now. I will share the PDF with you. I want you to just remember them. I will mark, remember this part. Only remember the ones which I'm marking. Okay. Remember this one. Okay. These two are important. Okay. So remember this one, and For sine x, remember only sine, remember the sine x. Only remember the sine x and remember cos x, this one. So these part you just remember, okay? Log x is important. Ax, a to the power x, sine x, and this one, okay? Fine? Okay. So now I will share the PDF with you. I hope today's class you were able to understand what I am what I was trying to share. Tell you this representation in terms of expansion. Yes. Very good. Very good. Very good, है ना? So you can do one thing. Once again, you can just check. You can once again, you can just revise the notes which I have taught you today, and then we will solve. Now I think you are able to solve more and more questions from your Seekers material also, है ना? Acha, yeah, three blue. Yes. Videsh, I was wondering what is the name of that this thing. Yes, I will recommend. Next, I will take the pick and I will show. I will send share that video. That is a very nice video. Yeah, three blue, one brown. Yes, I forgot that what was the name. Yes, that is a very nice. I showed that in Fiji when I was teaching. Okay, so take care. Please solve the questions. Tomorrow we will almost finish the how to solve the limits question. Okay, some part is left. So let's see. Okay, I'm waiting for 2 minutes, don't worry. Okay, I'm muting myself, I'm waiting. You can just download the PDF, okay?
Hello, sir. Okay.